Alleluia! Make you sit down.
我不想叫你坐下。
But I'm going to.
可是
No, wait. Stand up. Stand up.
我们继续站立哦。
Let me tell you something. We're in the middle of a new moon phase right now.
我们现在是在这个新月的，我们将进入这个 new moon, right?
New moon.
Yeah, 我们将进入这个新的月朔。
And whenever there's a new moon, God has instructed His people to do several things.
因为每当我们进入一个的新月，就是一个的月朔的时候，其实神都有就是要指示他的子民有一些事情要做的。
For many of you from churches, you may not know this, but He told His people on the new moon to sound shofars.
我们在教会的可能不知道这个，可是呢，在圣经里面说，在每一个的月朔里面呢，在新月的时候，我们要吹号角。
Every new moon, when you sound the shofar, it activates a new monthly cycle of fruitfulness and blessing.
因为在每一个的月朔，当你吹号角的时候，就是启动又一轮的一个新鲜的那一个的祝福在你的生命里面。
The last new moon was the Feast of Trumpets.
在过去的那个月朔是个吹角节。
And God not only began a new yearly cycle, He began a 10-year cycle.
所以神不单只就是有每一年的一个的循环，他还有一个十年的循环。
So even as you blow tonight, or you make the sound of the shofar by clapping,
所以今天晚上不论我们是吹号角，或者是我们用拍掌来做这个号角的声音，
you're activating fruitfulness in your life.
你是在启动这个多结果子的这个祝福在你的生命里面。
In your family, in your generations,
在你的这个的家族里面。
You're activating blessing in your city.
你在启动祝福临到香港这个地方。
You're activating blessing in your land.
你在启动祝福临到这个土地。
And you activate blessing in the earth.
你也是在全球在启动这个祝福。
Amen.
Amen.
It's also, since it's the beginning of a cycle of fruitfulness, it's also a good time to offer to the Lord.
所以既然这个是一个就是多结果子的那一个的开始，一个一轮的祝福，也在这个时候，其实我们也是很好的来，就是把我们的奉献带到神的面前。
Now we're not going to take an offering tonight where you pass a basket around or those kind of things. We're not going to do that.
所以今天晚上我们不会就是传袋子让你就是把你的奉献放进去。
We have two large banners up here. These are banners in which you can come and give your offering. Each of these banners speaks something about the future of Hong Kong, the future of China, and Hong Kong in China.
这个我们在前面有两个很大的这个的旗帜，所以你等一下就是你可以来把你的奉献放在上面，两片旗帜都有它就是特别的，就是说到在中国的祝福，就是还有香港的祝福，还有香港在中国里面的祝福。
In the current state that Hong Kong is in,
现在香港这个局势。
at this critical time,
这是一个很关键的时刻。
More than ever before, at the beginning of this new 10-year period.
这个是就发生在这一个十年的循环的开始的这一段时间。
Tonight is a night to worship like you've never worshipped before.
所以今天晚上我们的敬拜要崭新的，完全好像没有这样子的。兴奋的，就是努力的、卸力的敬拜，这样子在主面前敬拜。
It's a night to give like you've never given before.
然后今天晚上我们要就是把所有的从来就是倾倒在这些奉献的钱，这个金钱的奉献上面。
Now I'm going to tell you something. If you come tonight and you don't have something to give, then you come up, take something that someone else has already given, you take it, thank the Lord, and give that.
所以今天晚上，如果是你没有你觉得你没有金钱的话，你可以上到来这里，在这里你可以抓起一把的钱，然后感谢神，然后再放回去。
We don't want anyone going out of here without activating every dimension of blessing possible tonight.
因为我要今天晚上我们这里每一个人，你都有启动这一个的财富，这一个的祝福在你里面被启动起来。
So now tonight, do things like you've never done them before.
所以今天晚上我们要全新的来做这些事情。
They're going to sing one more song.
好，他们会在敬拜团队会再来唱一首歌。
You can use this time to come up and give if you want. When Chuck comes, you can come up during that time. Any time from now till the rest, till we're finished tonight, you can give.But worship as you give.
所以当你可以在敬拜的时候，你可以上前来，就是来奉献，或者是待会儿唱，使徒在讲道的时候，你听到有就是你阿门的那个信息，你也可以来前面，也可以放下你的奉献。
This is our time. This is the time for Hong Kong to make the shift.
因为这个是香港来要转换。
This is the time for Hong Kong to pivot. To pivot.
这是一个主要，这是很主要香港的这一个的时刻。
Somebody has to do it first.
所以总要有一群人。
You come be the first on this new moon when the first is offered to God.
你先把你的奉献，你成为那个第一个。把这位奉献带到前面来的。
一年前，求主给我你的眼光，不平其义，前方道路你为我照亮，你是为我征战的神的神诗歌，你是不能拦阻我一生紧紧紧紧跟随你。这是我的神的歌，你是有着诱惑的神，面对惧怕大声赞美，哦，哈利路亚，唱着一首的神的歌，给我力量超越险况，放眼前方应许之地，哈利路亚，不再畏惧。不平眼前，求主给我你的眼光，不平其义，前方道路你为我照亮，你是为我征战一生的神诗歌，谁都不能拦阻我一生紧紧紧紧跟随你，你就是我的神的歌，是有着诱惑的神，面对惧怕大声赞美，哦，哈利路亚，唱着一首大声的歌，有你能超越牵挂，放眼前方应许之地，哈利路亚，不再畏惧。有困难，我心仍有大喜乐。感情不足，唱着这首的圣歌。你就是我一切盼望的结局。 神，大神，大神，大神。虽有困难，我心仍有大喜乐。
大喜乐，
弹琴苦楚，唱着这首歌声歌。就是我一切盼望的结局，
一切盼望的结局。
大声大声大声大声，你就是我的声的歌，你是有真有活的神。面对惧怕大声赞美，哦，哈利路亚，唱着一首大声的歌，给我力量超越险况，放眼前方应许之地，哈利路亚，不再畏惧。
Now, let's just give a shout of victory already.
好，让我们来发出一个胜利的呼喊。
Wow. You can just feel the Lord's presence here.
你真的可以感觉到神的同在在这里。
I thank God for each one of you being here.
我真的是很感谢神把你们带到来这里，每一位。
I believe the timing of this meeting is very strategic for Hong Kong.
我相信这一场聚会呢，是真的是啊。在香港一个很关键很关键的时刻。
There are moments that God ordains.
我们生命里面人生会有一些的特别的时刻是神特地的。
And during those moments, he calls his remnant together.
就是在那这些时刻呢，他会把他的余民带在一起。
And it says if the Lord needed a people worshiping tonight.
所以说神他需要今天晚上有一群的人来敬拜他。
So I want you to thank the Lord for yourself and your obedience.
所以我要你为你自己来感谢神，因为今天晚上你很顺服的来到这里。
Because if you hadn't listened to him, we wouldn't be here.
因为如果你不是聆听他的话，你今天晚上就不会在这里。
So it was very, very important that we gathered.
所以我们要就是奉他的名聚集在一起，这是很重要的。
Now I have been very focused on praying for Asia.
我在过去就是很专注的为亚洲来祷告。
As we're entering this new era, it becomes very important that we understand the importance of China.
所以当我们进入这一个新的一个的时代的时候，我们要明白这一个关于中国的事情。
In 1980, God called me to pray for the Chinese people.
在1980年开始，神就呼召我来为华人祷告。
He called me to pray for the nation of China.
他也呼召我就是为中国这块地图来祷告。
Now that's been...40 years.
这个已经是有三四十年的时间了。
And so it's been a long journey praying for God's people here in China.
所以过去这个是一个很漫长的一个日子来为就是神的子民就是华人来祷告。
And many of you know that in 1986, God visited me.
很多人都知道，就是在1980年的时候，神造访我。
And revealed to me what would be happening in the church in 10-year increments.
然后就是让我知道每十年，就是神的那一个的基督的身体会发生什么事情。
I've written 3 books that are linked with that.
然后接着我就写了有三本书都有关这些事情。
All of those books are in Chinese.
这些书都已经翻译成中文。
Future War of the Church.
就是教会未来的战争。
God's unfolding battle plan.
就是神的那一个的
God's unfolding battle plan. God's
就是打开他的那一个的征战的策略。
and a time to triumph.
还有就是那一个得胜时刻。
Now, in 1986, God didn't reveal to me what would happen in the American church.
在1986年的时候，神其实神没有跟我说美国的那一个的教会会怎么样。
He revealed to me the changing church worldwide.
他开始让我看到就是在全球那个基督的身体会怎么有一个改变。
But the nation he used to reveal that to me was China.
他神就用中国这个地方这个国家来把这些事情来启示给我知道。
I have that outline in several of those books.
我在这好几本书都写了这一些的大这这一这这的大纲。
You say, well, why did he reveal it to you?
你可能问就是为什么他就是偏偏就是只向你去启示呢？
Well, I don't know. I guess I was the one listening.
我不知道，可能因为就是只有我在听吧。
And so because I was listening, God could share with me what was going to be happening in China over the next 40 years.
所以因为我有我就是我有去专注的是聆听神，所以他就把接着40年的这些事情就启示给我知道。
When I was here the last time, I shared about the 10-year cycle that we were coming into.
所以上一次我在这里的时候，我也分享了，就是我们将要进入这个十年的一个的循环。
Alan just mentioned that.
刚刚亚伦使徒有谈论到这些事情。
But also in that timeline that God gave me.
当然可是也是在这一个神给我的这一个的时间那个的就是时间表里面。
The Lord showed me that 2020 would be the key year of China.
然后神也就是告诉我，这时间表里面呢，2020年呢将是中国一个很关键的时刻。
Now look at someone next to you and say, "We're almost there."
跟你旁边那位那个人说，我们快要到了。
Actually, in the Hebrew calendar, we've already shifted into that time.
其实在犹太人日历呢，我们已经进入了。
And so now, the coming year ahead, China becomes the focus of the world.
所以在接着下来的这些的日子，中国将会是全球注目的地方。
Now,Tell someone next to you, I think he's talking about us.
跟旁边人说，我想他是在说我们。
So, we're very excited about what's happening in China.
所以我们现在，我们是真的是很对关于在中国要发生的事情，我们是很兴奋的。
I have some good friends here that I've walked with for years and years.
我有一些很好的朋友，在过去我跟他们同行了好多年。
We've been watching God get us to this time frame.
我们就是在过去就是在同行中看着神把我们带进入这一个的时间里面。
I thank God for Camp and Bart gathering us together.
我今天晚谢谢就是Cam 跟 Bart 把我们就是召集起来。
I thank God for the worship tonight.
我也感谢就是为感谢主今天晚上这个敬拜团队。
Because tonight becomes very important in Hong Kong.
因为今天晚上真的是在香港的这个历史里面是很重要很重要的一天。
Now, let me share some things with you that will help you.
好，让我来跟你们分享一些事情。
Everyone say out loud, the new era is here.
每个人说，那新的时代已经在这里了，我们已经进入新的时代了。
Now, as Alan said, we just didn't change into a new year.
好像刚才亚伦说的亚伦史伦说，我们不是只是这样子进入一个新的一年。
Since 1972, I have been going by God's calendar.
因为在1972年，我已经开始就是守这个神的那个日历。
The Lord wrote this covenant plan to us around the harvest time.
因为神是照着就是他丰收的时间呢，把他的那个的盟约启示给我们。
Because he always wanted us to keep a harvest mentality.
因为神就是要我们就常常有就是有这一个丰收就是收割的这一种的思维。
And so a month ago we shifted into a new era.In Hebrew 5780.
所以差不多一个月前呢，我们就已经是转换进入一个新的时代，五七八零年。
Now in our calendar, we will shift in to the fullness of that era in January.
就如果是我们西历的话呢，我们就会在一月的时候，我们才进入这个2020年。
I have always been amazed at the Chinese culture and language.
我常常就是我们中文中华的华人的文化，常常就是令我觉得很诧异。
Because some way it closely relates to God's covenant plan.
因为我们中国我们华人的文化呢，跟神的他那个的盟约的那一个的。计划是很相似的。
That's one of the reasons that I always knew he would use the Chinese people to become the prototype of the next move of God worldwide.
所以我就知道神会将会使就是要使用华人来成为他正要在全球的运行的那一个的一种一个的主要的这种的代表人物。
So in Isaiah 32 verse 1, it says a king will reign in righteousness in a new era.
所以在以赛亚书32章1节说，那个君王要在新的一个时代里面来去治理。
So when we shifted into this new era at Rosh Hashanah,
所以当我们在这个犹太人新年的时候，我们进入这一个新的一个的时代。
All of a sudden, the heavens started shifting.
这突然间，这个整片的在天上的这个天空都开始了转换。
And the earth started shifting.
然后土地也在转换。
And all of a sudden, God started rearranging the earth realm.
然后神就是在重新的来去排列次序，把这个地图排列次序。
Political leaders will be rearranged.
甚至是政治人物，每一个国家带领人物也会有一个的转换。
I decree tonight in Hong Kong a new rearrangement.
我今天晚上在香港这里，我宣布将会有一个新的转换在香港。
This begins the rearrangement.Of a new era with a new political realm in Hong Kong.
香港将会有一个新的政治的一个的转换发生在香港。
And see, without God's people coming and making decrees like that, nothing happens.
所以如果没有人聚集在一起来发出神的这个的颁布他的命令的话，就没有事情会发生。
You have to remember, God knew you before the foundation of the earth.
你要知道，神在创世之前，他已经认识我们了。
But he set you into time.
可是他就把我们放在他的时间里面。
God's not in time, but we're in time.
神不是在这个没有局限在这个时间里面，可是我们是在时间里面。
And even though you've been around for a long, long time.
所以可能你已经就是在活了好几十年了。
God needed you now in this time.
神现在仍然需要你，就是现在。
And he needed you here.In this time.
然后他需要你就是在这刻此时此刻在这里他需要你。
Acts 17 says he predetermines your place and your time.
使徒行传17章说我们的那个的疆界我们住在哪里都是神所画的。
God himself needed you here tonight.
所以今天晚上神需要你在这里。
And as you worship him, all of a sudden things start happening.
所以当我们聚集起来，我们一起敬拜他的时候，突然间事情就开始转换，有个改变。
Look at someone next to you and say, "He's all you're all he's got to work with."
跟你旁边的人说，你就是那一个他要在生命里做工的。
Therefore, without us being here,
所以如果我们不在这里的话,
he doesn't do anything.
他就不做工了。
So this becomes very important.
所以就是那么重要。
Now, let me show you what the symbol looks like of the number 80.
我们来看这一个八十这一个的那一个的数目的图像代表什么
There's a reason God gave us his covenant plan in Hebrew.
神用这个希伯来文来展现他的那一个的盟约的计划是有他的原因的
Because Hebrew is a whole language.
Whole. Okay, 因为啊希伯来文是很它的那一个的它是很完整的、
every number has word meaning
每一个的数目字都有一个字的意思代表它
every word has sound meaning
然后每一个字呢都有一个的声音
so 80 is linked with new beginning
所以80的意思就是新的开始
But it's linked with developing our testimony in a new beginning.
可是它的那个是关于我们有一个新的见证。
But 80 has other meanings to it.
80也有另外一些意思。
Go ahead, John, and let's look at it. See, here's a better picture of what it looks like.
这个是更好的代表这个80是什么意思。
80 is...It actually means we're coming face to face with the Lord.
它意思就是我们将要，就是我们要跟主面对面。
Now, what does that mean to us?
是什么意思呢？与主面对面。
It means that all of a sudden we're becoming what God would have us be for the future.
就是突然间我们会成为神要在未来他要我们成为的那一个人。
80 is linked with.The sound of the roar.
然后八十也是就是那个吼叫的那个的声音。
So as we're coming face to face with the Lord, He's roaring.
所以当我们与主面对面的时候，他就是在对着我们吼叫。
Therefore, the roar in us is being activated.
然后就启动在我们里面的那个的吼叫。
Now, why do you think that's happening?
所以你就问为什么要发生
的这件事 Because it's the era where the warfare in the earth realm intensifies.
因为呢，在全球的那一个的属灵战争将会很激烈。
But the Lord says, I've got a people in the earth that have a sound.
可是神说，我在这个全球上有一群的子民，他是拥有我的声音的。
I have a people in the earth who sound like me.
然后我有一群子民，他们就是他们跟我的那个的声音很相像。
Because what I call this next 10 years,
因为这个将要这前面的这十年
is the season of dragon and lion wars.
是。将会是这龙跟狮子战争的十年。
Do you know what that means?
你们知道这是什么意思吗
？That means China.
那个就是中国的意思。
The dragon.
因为是
nation.
龙的国家就是中国。
Will now be in the forefront of the world over these next 10 years.
在前面的这十年，它中国将会走到很前线。
But unless God's people rise up with the sound of heaven,
所以神的子民必须要带着这个天堂的声音来兴起来。
We won't be able to set the course correctly for.This nation and this people.
所以，如果我们不这样子做的话，我们就不能够把这个国家带进神的道路上面去，把华人带进，就是走在神的道路上。
Therefore, there's going to be great war between Judah.
所以将会有就是犹大的狮子
and the dragon nation.
就是犹大的狮子将会跟龙的国家将会有个很激烈的战争。
Now what does that mean? It means the dragon nations are going to become the most incredible worshiping lands in the earth realm.
那个意思就是说，所有在地球上这些属于龙的国家呢，将会成为呢，这一个就是很激烈敬拜神的地方。
Therefore, I decree tonight a new wave of worship.
所以今天晚上我颁布就是这个命令，就是将会有新的敬拜要进入。
Will begin to sweep across China.
新的敬拜要传遍这个全中国。
A new wave of worship will rise up in Hong Kong.
一个新鲜的敬拜要在香港兴起。
And all of a sudden, the atmosphere of the dragon lands will be aligned with heaven.
所以突然间这一个龙的国家将会突然间就是跟神对齐。
See, when we start seeing who we are,
所以你看到吗？就是当我们了解，当我们看见我们是谁，
God starts using us today.
神就今天他就会拣选我们。
Now let me explain this a little further as we look at Hong Kong now.
好，现在我们要来再我们深入的再来看香港。
See, the real war that we've entered into right now is determining our identity for the future.
所以我们现在所进入的这一个的战争呢，是将要就是展现来我们在未来的那一个的身份。
Who are we?
就是我们是谁。
What do we look like?
我们的样貌是怎么样的呢？
What do we sound like?
我们的声音是怎么样的呢？
See, all of a sudden God's saying, I must have a people who identify with me.
因为突然间神这样子说，他要有一群的子民是与他一起的 identify, 就是很像他的，跟他一起连接的。
Become one with me.
呀，跟他一起连接成为一。
And that's where we get into the crisis of Hong Kong.
所以就是因为这样子，所以香港今天的局势就这样子混乱。
Over the last several decades, the identity of Hong Kong has been changing.
在过去的几十年，我们看到就是香港的他的那个身份都在就是有一个的转变。
It was British, and all of a sudden it became Chinese.
本来是英殖民地，后来现在就变成是我们就是回到中国成为就是属于中国的。
But in the midst of it, I'm not sure the people knew who they were.
可是我相信就是在这个转变里面呢，可能我们香港人还没有抓着得到就是我们的身份到底是什么。
So in the natural realm,There's a striving to become who Hong Kong is for today.
所以在自然界里面呢，香港人就在有一个的争取我们要成为什么人。
Who is Hong Kong?
所以谁是香港人呢？
And yet, look at this remnant in this room.
你看看四围，看看今天晚上在这里所有的神的余民在这里。
This is three times what Gideon had.
在这里的那个人数是比基甸那三百还要多。
When Gideon.
是二三倍呀。Yeah.
This is three times what Gideon had in his army.
就是基甸的军队，我们今天晚上的数目比基甸军队还
多三倍。Now, why am I saying that?
我为什么这样子说呢？
In the midst of a natural identity crisis.
因为在我们的这个我们的自然人的那一个的身份的混乱里面。
Just think if God's people rise up and become who God's called them to be.
你想象就是当神的子民兴起来成为神要他们成为的人，
All of a sudden they tip the scale.
突然间他们就会把这一个的那一个的就是那一个的真理，就是那一个的就是那个天平就是往这一边倾倒了。
Now, with thatWhy is it difficult to get into a new identity?
所以为什么那么要进入一个新的身份是那么困难呢？
Well, for us to shift, we have to resist number one, fear.
因为当我们要转换，我们要转变，进入一个新的时代的时候，我们首先要克服的就是那恐惧。
All of a sudden, in an identity shift, lots of fear begins to spread.
所以当我们在转换我们那个进入这新的身份的时候，就是很多恐惧会跑出来。
The spirit of fear begins to rise up.
那一个恐惧的灵就是会这样子兴起来。
And then the second thing we have to come into agreement with is who is God saying that we are?
然后第二个我们要同意的我们要跟神连接的就是神说我们是谁。
The third thing is it's a new era.
然后第三点呢就是现在是一个新的时代。
Everyone say new.
我们每一个人说新的。
Well,Anytime you're entering a new era, you have to give space.
因为当我们每一次进入一个新的时代的时候，我们就要挪去，使到有空间，我们可以进入。
Because there's a lot of conflict and a lot of chaos.
因为将会有很多的冲突，很多的混乱。
There's a lot of confusion.
然后有很多的矛盾，很多的混淆。
And if you don't give enough space,You will begin to harm what God is doing.
所以如果你没有给他空间的话，你就会伤害，将会伤害神要做的事情。
Now, about 7 months ago, I sent a word to many of the church leaders in China.
大概在七个月前，我就把一些的话语传递了给一些在中国的领袖。
In that word, I began to explain how China was coming into a whole new power dimension.
在那些的话语里面，就是有说到中国将会要进入一个全新的一个就是全球的那一个的权力，那一个的全球 power 能力呀。Yeah.
And I said.This is how the church in China is going to have to move forward.
所以呢，就是在中国的教会将要需要这样子的去前进。
And I said riots are going to break out.
我跟他们说，就是暴动会在中国
天地发生。This will be a sign of the confusion of all the change.
因为这个就是那一个进入这一个崭新的改变所带来一些的混乱。
Well, within a couple of months, riots started breaking out.
所以在几个月之后呢，就真的是有这些的动乱就开始发生了。
But one word I said was that God's people now are starting to develop their voice.
其中一个的话语，我说的，我对这些领袖说的就是，神的子民正在就是发展他们的声音。
Now, this is what you have to understand. The church in China,
我们要知道
mainland China,
就是在中国的教会
and the church in Hong Kong,
然后在香港的教会
and the Chinese church in Taiwan,
然后在台湾的这华人的教会
and the Chinese church in Malaysia,
然后在马来西亚的华人教会
and the Chinese church in Indonesia
在印尼的华人教会
and the Chinese church in Vietnam
在越南的华人教会
they're all one church
其实都是一个教会
therefore when God is moving
所以呢当神在向前进的时候
he's moving beyond national crisisInto kingdom development.
它不是只是在这一个国家领域层面来去运行，而是在它的国度来进行。
So this is what he said to me.
所以他跟我说了这些话。
He said, "The lion of the tribe of Judah must develop its roar throughout China."
所以那个犹大狮子将犹大狮子呢，要在中国这个全地要展有一个展示，有一个要建立他的那一个的吼叫的声音。
Because when Judah begins to roar,
因为当 犹大来哄教的时候。
Amos chapter 3 says this.
亚摩西书第三章。
It creates an atmosphere.
第三章如此说，当这个狮子吼叫的时候呢，它就会带来一个新的氛围，在属灵氛围。
Completely different from what is going on in the earthly realm.
啊，是跟这个地上所那一个的氛围是完全不一样的。
I am here to announce to you tonight.
所以今天晚上我在这里宣告。
Judah is rising up in China.
啊，在犹大的狮子已经在中国兴起来了。
There is a sound rising up in God's people.
因为在神的子民里面有一个声音出来了。
Beginning tonight when this sound comes forth.
所以今天晚上开始这个声音就要发出去。
All of a sudden the atmosphere must take on that sound.
所以突然间这一个氛围这属灵的氛围就要跟着这个声音改变。
The sound coming out of this meeting must be greater than the confusion that's going on in the city of Hong Kong.
所以今天晚上在这里发出的声音必定要比在外面的那个混乱更大。
Because here's what the year is and the decade and the entire era is about.
因为这个就是啊，这个前面的十年，这个新的时代。
It's about commanding a new opening.
就是要来去命令有个新的打开。
Here are two key scriptures for you.
这里有两个很主要的经文。
Declare a thing and it will be established.
啊，一个就是你 declare， 就是你宣告一样事情，它就会被建立。
Therefore, the moment we start declaring tonight,
所以今天晚上当我们一旦我们来开始宣告的时候
and we start speaking,
我们一开始来说话的时候
the atmosphere starts changing.
当我们用我们的话语来宣告的时候，那一个的氛围，属灵氛围就要改变。
The same way with your life personally.
这个也是关乎我们每个人个人的生命。
The things that God has spoken to you in the past.
啊，这些神在过去啊，关乎你有所讲的，关乎你生命的那些事情。
In this season, you decree them, and all of a sudden, they're established.
所以在这个季节里面，你就是要去拿着这些的应许，你要去。啊、宣告突然间就会在你生命里面成就。
See, declare a thing is the same type of word that's linked with the number 80.
因为在经文里面说那个你宣告一些事情是跟那一个八十的意思是相同的。
But look at this next scripture.
啊，我们来看这另下一个的那经文。
The Holy One of Israel says this.
就是以色列的圣者如此说。
Ask me about things to come for my sons and my daughters.
就是你为着我的子民来啊寻求我。
And then command and give me orders.
啊，然后就是啊。命令我要把这些事情按秩序的排列起来。
Are you aware that in this new era, God is saying you can command my hand to move?
所以你要知道吗？在这个新的时代里面呢，我们可以命令神的手。
You can look at the generation ahead.
你可以就是往前看好几代以后。
And you can say what needs to be said.
你可以向着这前面的好几代以后，你可以就是发颁发神的命令。
So that that generation can be secure in me.
好让这些以后的这些的啊世代能够在神里面得着稳固。
Now that's one of the reasons we're here tonight.
所以就这个是其中一个为什么今天晚上我们聚集在这里。
Now, I'm going to ask you to do something.
啊、我要大家来做一件些事情。
If you are 40 years of age or above, stand up.
如果你是40岁以上的，请你站立起来。Yes.
All right. Now look around.
好，你们到处，你们看看你们周围。
That means you are carrying last season's prophetic word and prophetic will within your blood.
意思是说，在我们这里的每一位，就是你们在你们的生命里面都有这过去季节里面的那一个的先知性的预言。
Now you may be seated.
好，请你，请你先坐下。
Now if you are 40 years or younger, stand up.
如果是你四十岁以下的，请你站起来。
Now notice what God is saying in this verse.
啊，你啊，神在这经文是这样子说的。
What He's saying is that the generation that stood up first.
啊，刚才先站立起来的那一个世代，那一个那一代的人
，can command Him to move on your behalf.
可以就是为现在你们这一代，可以就是吩咐神的手要动在你们的生命里面。
Now put your hand on someone around you.
好，我们把手放在我们这周围的一些人的身上。
And say, God's ready to get you moving forward.
神已经预备好要就是把你启动起来，让你前进。
Now let me explain this. You may be seated.
现在我们可以坐下，让我来解释这是什么意思。
This is what the war in the atmosphere is over Hong Kong.
这个就是现在在香港这一个属灵天空的那一场战争。
The enemy wants to rob the next generation's future.
因为这个仇敌要掳掠，要夺去我们下一代的那一个他们的未来。
Say no.
我们跟他说不。
And it's as if tonight, if we didn't shift.
所以，如果今天晚上我们没有来一个转换的话
，Hong Kong would not be what it's called to be.
香港将不能成为神命定它要成为的。
And the next generations will suffer.
然后下一代就会受苦。
So the Lord is giving us great authority tonight to make a shift.
所以今天晚上神给我们有很这个很大的权柄来把这一个事情来转换过来，转移。
A spiritual authority.
就是属灵的权柄。
Now let me show you what 80 also looks like.
然后我们再来看这个80是代表什么。
It means what you say reflects your freedom.
意思说你所说的就是代表你那一个的自由度。
And our freedom is going to come through our relationship with the Lord.
我们的真自由是我们跟神的那关系里面来的。
It means that we have the ability to set ambushments.
意思说我们有这一个的能力来去突袭。
So that we don't get ambushed.
来去突袭仇敌，使到我们不被他来。
It means we're raising up a new priesthood.
就是我们兴起一个新的祭司。
In this new era, we're calling forth a new generation of priests and kings.
因为在这个时代，新的时代，我们是在呼唤这个新的一代的祭司跟君王起来。
Here's the thing you have to understand about the era we've entered into.
我们要明白我们现在进入的是一个什么的时代。
It's not just an era of truth.
不是只是一个真理的时代。
It is an era of supernatural movement.
是一个超自然运作的一个的时代。
Therefore, if we don't move by the Spirit of God,
所以如果我们不是在灵里面来进行的话
we won't have the authority to change what needs to be changed.
我们就没有那个权柄来去改变那些需要改变的。
Here's a few more things.
还有其他。另外几件
Go ahead, John. Now, it also is linked with not only how we speak.
所以不单止80是跟我们的那个的言语有关联。
But it is linked with how we are decreeing our future.
也是就是有关乎我们会如何去命令我们的未来。
It's linked with the ability to call forth the wind and create a new order.
那它是有跟那个我们能够就是把 就是启动圣灵的风，把呼唤圣灵的风来吹在全地上，吹在这个是就是那个句式里面的那一个的这一个的关联。
The word is also linked with confusion and rioting.
啊，然后那一个的啊，也是有跟这个动乱跟那个混乱有那个关联。
But in the midst of it, God gives us the authority.
啊，可是在这一切的动乱之间呢，在其中，神给我们有那一个的权柄。
To decree that the latter will be greater than the former.
我们去发命令，就是末后的要比先前的更荣美。
So it is linked with us being delivered from chaos.
所以就是意思是说，我们也是将会从混乱里面被释放出来。
I know of no place throughout the entire world.
我知道在全球再没有一个这样子的地方。
That reflects this year better than Hong Kong.
就是没有在全球没有在另外一个地方能够把今年的那一个的，就是5780年这一个的，在神里面灵界的那一个的样貌，把它展现出来。
That's why the Lord asked me to fly back here and be with you at this beginning of this month.
所以我特地的就是特别的要在这一个月朔里面来到今天晚上来到这里。
Because this is the month that you start shifting out of chaos and coming into a new order of God.
因为在今天晚上我们进入这个月朔将会是从这个混乱进入神的那个次序里面。
Here's another issue.
这还有另外一件事情。
Here's another issue. It becomes an issue where we have a war of thrones.
这个也是一个就是那个宝座，就是谁掌权的那个的一个的争权夺利的时间。
In the midst of that, we have a divine rearrangement of worship going on.
在这个之间呢，在这场战争之间呢，就有一个新的神圣的，就是神会有个新的神圣的排列在我们的敬拜里面。
Because over Hong Kong there is a throne being established for worship for the future.
因为现在香港呢，神正在建立他的那一个敬拜的宝座。
Now this is why Hong Kong becomes so important for us.
所以香港是那么的重要。
Isaiah 28.
我们看以赛亚书二十八章。
Now notice what this chapter says.
Okay, yeah.
It's linked with this month.
这个经文里面所说的就是跟这一个月朔是有关的。
The glory of God is at the gate.
神的那个荣耀就是现在就在那个门。
But it also talks about how we must turn the battle at the gate.
然后也讲到我们就是在城门那里如何把那个战争转变过来。
How the glory is waiting to rest down at the gate.
就是那一个神的荣耀他正在等着就是要降临在这个城门那里。
But there's a battle that's trying to stop the glory from coming at the gate.
可是却有一股的那个仇敌的力量要来停止这件事情。
So the Lord says, I'll bring a spirit of justice in.
所以神说我会把这个一个公平的灵带进来。
And as I bring this spirit of justice in, a new strength will come and all of a sudden the battle at the gate will be driven back.
所以当这一个公正的这一个灵进入来的时候就会把这个会有一个新的力量把这个邪恶的力量把它赶走。
Here's what we have to understand.
我们要明白这一点。
Hong Kong is a gate.
因为香港是一个城门。
To all of Asia.
就是整个亚洲的城门。
Therefore, the enemy is saying, I want to control this gate.
所以仇敌要来得着这个门户，他要得着这个城门口。
And God is saying, but I have a people.
可是神说我有一群的子民。
I have a people who have a voice.
我有一群子民，他们有这个属于我的声音。
I have the tribe of Judah rising up.
我有这一个犹大的狮子在兴起来。
They have a roar within them.
在他们里面有这个吼叫。
And they will control the gate.
他们会来掌在这个城门口掌权。
And in this chapter, it's talking about a spirit of death that's resting at the gate.
然后在这个经文里面，这章节里面也说到有这死亡的灵来到这一个城门口。
And this spirit is warring against God's covenant blessings.
那这一个死亡的灵呢，是跟神的盟约来去征战的。
I am here to announce to you tonight.
我今天晚上在这里来宣告。
The gate called Hong Kong is now starting to shift.Into a new glory.
这个香港这一个的门户现在要转移进入一个新的荣耀里面。
Now I want us to stand up for a moment.
我们来一起的站立。
I want you to allow the Spirit of God.
我要我们大家来容让神的灵。
To rise up within you.
在我们里面兴起来。
And I want us to roar here at this gate called Hong Kong.
我们要来为香港这个城门口，我们要来呼喊，我们要来喊。
Now,
喊叫。
As we begin to roar.
当我们来吼叫的时候。
We're going to ask the Lord to change the justice system in this city.
我们要就叫神要在这个城市里面来转变这一个的这一个的正义在公平。
We're going to ask the Lord to redo the political workings of the city. Ask the Lord to redo the political workings of the city.
让神来重建我们这个政治。
The hidden operations.The hidden operations, hidden.
那一个隐藏的那一种的背后的那种动机。
Anytime you see hidden, you see occult working.
就是当有这种的隐藏这种的仇敌的工作，你知道就是有这种邪术巫术在当中。
I decree a stirring up in God's remnant people.
所以现在我宣告神的我们里面有个的搞动。
I decree a new opening coming between heaven and earth over Hong Kong.
有一个新的一个的天上有一个新的打开，把香港跟天上来有个连结。
I decree a new sound rising up in Hong Kong.
我宣告有个新的声音要在香港里面要兴起来。
I decree a new ruler anointing in Hong Kong.
我宣告有个新的治理权在香港。
Tonight, a shift in the present government of Hong Kong.
我现在宣告，香港的政府会有个转移。
And we say the new era starts tonight in Hong Kong.
今天晚上，香港进入新的时代。
Now there's two more things I want to show you tonight.
我还有两点我要让大家知道的。
The Lord this afternoon, and you may be seated for a second.
我们可以坐下。
The Lord this afternoon took me to 1 Kings 18.
那今天下午神让我看就是列王记上十八章。
Now this is where Elijah is in a great war over the change ahead.Of the entire structure of Israel.
这个就是说到就是以利亚先知正在就是正在处在以色列的那一个的政治里面有一个很大的改变，他在其中。
And so in the midst of it, all of a sudden, Elijah goes to war with the false structure that's ruling.
所以就是突然间以利亚就发就他就跟这一个虚假的那一个的仇敌的势力，当时在以色列掌控的这仇敌的势力在征战。
And he says to the people,
他就这样子跟以色列子民说。
How long will you be hung between two opinions?
他意思是说你要就是hung between, 在这悬挂在两者之间，你还要多久呢？
How long will you be dangling in between what you know should be?
就是你还就是对关于你知道你应该要成为怎么样的人，你还要卡在那里要多久呢？
How long will this stalemate continue? How long will this stalemate continue?
就是这样子。
Stalemate is where nothing is moving one way or the other.
就是你就是待在这样子的状况里面，不能前进，三心两意的，要多久呢？
Do you know what this word actually means in Hebrew?
你知道这个在希伯来文是真正它意思是什么吗？
It's the same word as Passover.
它跟那个逾越节的那个字眼是一样的。
How long will you stand and not pass over?
就是你还要站在那里多久不越过去？
That's what's happening in the atmosphere over Hong Kong.
所以现在就是香港的局势。
So the Lord said tonight.
所以神如此说，今天晚上。
And see, at Passover, Judah goes first.
因为在逾越节，就是犹大会先在前面，先前进。
Tonight, the Lord says, decree a Passover over Hong Kong.
神说，今天晚上你要在香港来命发。就是来发命令，这一个要发生一个逾越节。
Decree that the tug of war end.
就是那一个的角力要结束了。
Decree that what's not going or what's not moving break.
就是那个停止不前，不能前进的这一个的力量已经结束了。
Now let's stand up again.
好，我们再站立起来。
You can just stay up here with me.See, all of a sudden, when we make a decree like this,
所以突然，当我们这样子发出一个的命令的时候，
the atmosphere has to shift.
那个的属灵氛围必定要转移。
Right now, decree and say out loud, Passover in Hong Kong.
现在我们说，逾越节来到香港，逾越节发生在香港。
We decree, Lord, that you will cause this to go in a different direction.
我们说我们要把这一个就是把它赶出去，去另外一个方向。
Now let Judah roar again.
我们要来犹大的吼，狮子的吼叫，犹大狮子的吼叫。
We say an early Passover over Hong Kong.
天父，我说，我宣告一个有个一个就是就是一个这个逾越节要来到香港。
We say Hong Kong will not be able to stay the same starting now.
就从今天晚上开始，香港不会再如以前。
Be seated one more time.
好，我们请坐下，再来一次，请坐下。
I want to show you one more thing. See, when God's people, when you're being used by Him tonight.
你知道吗？我们今天晚上，我们是神的子民，我们其实神正在用我们来去做他的工作。今天晚上是他把我们带来这里。
There are certain things he couldn't have done tonight had not certain apostolic authority come tonight.
今天晚上如果没有这一个使徒性的那个权柄在我们当中，有些事情我们是不能做的。
See, what's happening is we're having to pull out of heaven.
因为我们必须要在天上把他的那个旨意拉下来。
Into the earth realm, the will of God.
把他的旨意拉到这个地上。
Remember, Elijah had to pull the rain out of heaven into the earth realm.
就好像以利亚要把那个雨水再从天上拉下来，拉到地上。
You're doing the same thing.
我们今天晚上也是做同样的事情。
You're realigning heaven and earth over Hong Kong.
你是把这个香港跟这神的掌权在天上掌权完全的是对齐。
You're causing Hong Kong to go into its future.
你们今天晚上在这里是使到香港能够进入它的未来。
You're causing it to become the gate it's called to be again.
你使到香港能够成为神呼召它成为那个城门口。
I love this city.
我真的很爱香港。
It hurts to see this city being robbed of its destiny.
真的、我看到我很心痛，当我看到香港就是仇敌这样子来去掳掠他的那一个的、
And so,
命定
what we've had to do
所以今天晚上
is to create a new atmosphere over this city.
所以我们要在这个城市里面要来去建立来去创造一个新的一个属灵氛围。所以今天晚上我们在这里就是做着这件事情。
You're causing a whole new portal.
你在打开一个 一个属灵的一个空间。
You're causing heaven and earth to realign.
你使到这一个的属灵的这一个的 portal 这一个的空间使到天跟地就是合一的。
I've been watching Aladdin on all of my flights. The movie Aladdin.
我在看就是阿拉丁 这套戏。
And there's a song in that movie that says I will not be silent.
在里面有一首歌说我不会再沉默。
The Lord brought me here tonight to say you can't be silent as God's people.
所以神今天晚上把我带来这里要跟你们说神的子民啊，你不可以再沉静不语，不能够再沉默。
You can't be caught between two opinions.
就是你不能够三心两意在两者之间摆动不定。
You have to say it's time for Hong Kong to shift.
所以你要说是香港要被转移的时候了。
Only you can create this portal.
因为只有我们，只有你们可以来去把这一个属灵的这个天空，这个的。门户打开。
God is swirling in heaven.
神正在这个天上，他在转
动。 But you have to bring it down to the earth realm.
而是你要把它拉下来到这个地上。
Now here's the last thing I want to say.
好，这是在最后我要分享的。
Can this shift in a day?
就是在一天之内就可以完全的转移吗？有可能吗？
Can tonight things really start shifting?
今天晚上就真正可以把事情转移吗？
I don't think it will be instant change, but I do think tonight we start seeing change.
我相信不是事情完全的突然的改变，可是我相信今天晚上我们将会开始看见有转变。
And here was the last thing the Lord showed me.
这是神在向我启示一个最后的一件事情。
When I flew in today to Hong Kong,
今天当我就是搭飞机进入香港的时候。
My third time to fly in here in 1 month.
这是我在
one month
在一个月里面我飞进来经过这里第三次了，到香港第三次。
I saw famine over the city.
我在这一个城市里面，我看到这一个的荒灾、饥荒、饥荒、饥荒。
And the Lord said, I want that shifted out of the atmosphere.
神说我要这个饥荒被转移离开这一个的属灵氛围。
Or else famine will begin to rule Hong Kong.
因为不然的话这个饥荒将会在这个地上治理。
And here's what you have to understand.
我们必须要明白一点。
China will shift its favor from here to somewhere else.
因为中国将会就是把它的对这个地的那个恩宠会转移到另外一个地方。
Say out loud, we don't want the favor to leave Hong Kong.
你要跟神说，我们不要这个恩宠离开香港。
See,I grew up in a family that had a lot.
你知道吗？我在我成长的家庭呢，我们拥有很多。
But then all of a sudden, favor started shifting off of that family.
可是后来呢，这一个恩宠呢，就离开了我们的家庭。
Because of all the conflict they got into.
因为我们的家中的成员进入有很多的冲突在当中。
God doesn't want Hong Kong.To lose its favor.
就是神不愿意香港失去他的那一个的恩宠。
And so here, the prophet prophesies something.
所以在这里呢，那一个先知他发预言。
In the midst of famine, he says this.
在那一个饥荒当中，这个先知如此说。
Tomorrow about this time.
就明天大概是这个的时间。
Things will change.
事情就将要改变了。
He says, if the Lord should make windows in heaven,
就是如果他说，如果神就是把这一个打开天窗，把这个天和地对齐
，like he did for Elijah when Elijah brought down rain,
就好像在以前就是希勒当以利亚就在天空把这个雨水拉下来。
Elisha now is saying, if God could do that,
所以以利沙说，如果希尔神可以这样子做，
He can do a shift at this gate starting now.
他可以现在就在我们的门户城门口就把这一个来转移。
And the famine that is controlling this city.
所以那个掌控在控制着我们这一个城市的那个饥荒
must be shifted out of the atmosphere.
一定要从我们属灵氛围里面被转移出去。
Now I want you to stand up.
我们再站起来。
I'm going to take my apostolic authority.
我现在要使用我的那一个使徒性权柄。
And decree every place that each one of us in this room go.
就是来发颁布这命令，就是在这房间里面，我们每一个人将要去的地方。
That we are carrying a sound.
我们是带着一个的声音。
That we're carrying a glory.
我们带着一个荣耀。
That we're walking in timing.
我们会在对的时间里面行走，在对的时间里面。
So that when we go all over this city,
我们会行走这整个片城市，到处行走。
All of a sudden, we say, "Famine, let go."
就突然间，我们就要说，饥荒，你要放开你的手。
Say it out loud, "Famine, let go."
饥荒，放开你的手。
In Yeshua's name,
奉耶稣的名字，饥荒要放开你的手。
Favor come,
恩宠降下来。
Favor come,
恩宠下来。
We speak it over the next generation.
我们向下一代的年轻人颁布这命令。
We speak it for the next generation.
我们为下一代年轻人来发命令。
We say that the ruling forces over this gate called Hong Kong.
我们说这个现在在这个城门口掌权的这个势力
are now shifting.
现在已经被转移了。
Shall change.
我们说，我们一起来大声呼喊。 改变
change
改变
change change
改变
change
改变
change
改变
change
改变
Shout change City to break.
我们说那个在这个城市的羞辱要断开，城市的羞辱要死要断开。
We say today.
我们说今天。
Today.
今天。
Today.
今天。
As it is called today.
就是今天。
We say a new faith rises up in Hong Kong.
我们说有股新的信心在香港兴起。
New alignments begin.
新的对齐，新的对齐要开始。
Fear breaks off.
恐惧要被断开。
Tell fear to go.
恐惧要离开。
Shout, future is here. Future is here.
你说说未来已经进入我们的时间里面了。未来进入我们的时间里面了。
Now turn, agree with two or three people around you.
好，我们两三个人聚在一起，我们来一起同意。
Where there's two touching and agreeing,
因为当两三
God will start working.
因为当两三个人同心合意的时候，神就会做工。